What's up, guys? Welcome back to another Music Producer Reacts video. My name is Joe Gautry and I'm a freelance producer based in London, and I'm excited for today's reaction video because it is the return of Adele. She took a couple of years off releasing music, but she is back with a new single called Easy On Me, and today we are going to be reacting to it and talking about all the cool aspects of the production as well as the songwriting. But before we do get into this video, hit that subscribe button because demonetization is real and this is definitely going to get copyright strike. Let's be honest, it's Adele. But I don't want to waste any more time because I want to hear this song. Let's react to it. This already sounds like an Adele song.
There ain't no gold in this river that I've been washing my hands in forever. I know there is hope in these waters, but I can't bring myself to swim when I am drowning in this silence.
There's some things about the vocal which is really interesting and I want to point out from a production point of view. There's a really good vocal mixing technique that's used in this vocal that I can hear, which I'm a massive fan of, mainly because of the effect it actually has on the performance of the vocal. Now, what am I talking about? So you hear Adele's vocal and it sounds so intimate. She's recording close to the microphone because there's a little bit of proximity effect going on, very low bassy tone to her voice. So Adele's voice has a reverb on it. It's very bright, it's very subtle, very airy is the best way to put it. Now, this is achieved using a sidechain compressor. Now, the reason why the vocal is sidechained to this compressor in the reverb bus is because the compressor will be set to a certain setting that when the vocal goes below a certain volume, the compressor is going to ramp up the reverb. Now, while Adele is singing, the reverb will be pushed to the back of the mix by the compressor, meaning that we get the detail in Adele's voice and it brings across the emotion a lot more because it's a lot more raw and a lot more personal sounding. But we want to keep atmosphere in the vocal as well, so we bring the reverb back up once she stops singing, so then we get that atmosphere and ambience. Also, in terms of production, there's piano, and in the chorus, there's the addition of a bass, which adds a little bit of development. With Adele's songs, you can honestly just have her piano and voice, because her voice tends to carry the song a lot. Her voice is really at the front of the mix, and the piano, even though it's really nicely mixed and it's got a nice low end to it, the piano to sort of add to the low section, I mean, the bass doesn't have to do as much work. Sometimes it's better to be simple in these kinds of songs.
Child,
I'm just completely paused there because there's a lot of things that I noticed and I kind of wanted to say them before we got to the end of the song in case there was anything else. So what I found really interesting about the start of the second verse is the bass was playing a legato in the chorus. Now, the song almost sounded like it sped up a lot more because the bass started playing almost like a sort of funky beat in the background, which added a little bit more of a tempo, to the song. One thing, again, I really want to point out about Adele's voice as well is this is something that I can refer back to a past song of hers called Set Fire to the Rain, where there's been production talks on it about the way her vocals are mixed again. Now, on this, what I'm implying is the use of autotune, which we know is very prominent in all productions. You can listen to any song in the charts today and there'll be autotune on the vocal because that's just the norm now. It's a really quick way to clean up vocals and you can use autotune in really great ways, but Adele's voice, what I find really interesting is the complete lack of autotune in her voice, and there's always been a lack of autotune. Now, the reason for this is because autotune can kind of take the soul out of a voice sometimes. This is very gospely, and Adele's voice, we all know it's on point. She can sing incredibly, and one thing about her performance is the sort of raw nature of it and the real passion she puts into her voice and the vocal slides and stuff. And you put autotune on, it's going to ruin it. Now, there are times in a song where Adele slides into notes, meaning that she starts singing certain notes out of tune, but that's not a bad thing because, again, it's them slides which help complete the performance of a vocal, and this is one of the reasons why Adele's songs are so emotional and have such a great storytelling aspect about them. I had no time to choose what I chose to do, so go easy on me. I like that long fade out of the piano at the end. Too many songs nowadays end abruptly. A nice long fade out from the piano makes it sound a lot more natural and sound a lot more like a performance, the song. It's not a song, it's a performance. Coming in at 3 minutes 44, the structure of the song was pretty generic of a pop song. You had verse, pre-chorus, chorus, verse, pre-chorus, chorus, bridge, and then an end chorus, which is slightly different from the other choruses. That isn't a dig. That is the structure for 99% of pop songs in the charts. And I think this song, it's a good Adele song. Listening to this song, you could literally put this on without saying who the artist singing is, and straight away you'd be like, that's Adele. I'm almost quite glad that she hasn't tried to go away and go down a different sound. This is Adele, this is what she does best, so I'm glad that she's sticking to that. And in terms of the productions, it was simple, but with Adele, simple is always best. Don't want to overcomplicate these sorts of things. You don't want big production of the song because you almost want to have that sort of intimacy in the production, and you want the production to always match the performance of the vocal, because otherwise you just got two contrasting elements trying to come together at once. But yes, guys, that was my reaction to Adele. Go easy on me. What do you rate this song out of 10? Comment below what you rate this song out of 10. I'm really interested to see what you think of it. And if you did enjoy this video and made it to this far, then hit that subscribe button if you enjoyed this video, of course, because it's the best way to support this channel. And if you're interested in learning music production as well, then I also have loads of tutorials on how you can make music yourself. So again, subscribe to my channel to see all of them videos. But thank you for watching, guys. Keep making music, and I will see you in the next video.